Hey guys, this video I wanted to show one of my favorite attacks from Closed Guard. It's just a basic setup for an armbar, but there's a lot of small details that make it a lot more effective that you guys might have been missing.
We're just gonna start in Closed Guard. So the first thing to understand anytime you're attacking from Closed Guard is I have to break whatever grips he's posturing with first. You may have seen me cover this before. The three main ways is the guy's either gonna have both hands high in my armpit, he's gonna have both hands low on the hip, or he's gonna go one high, one low like this. Okay, so to progress to any attack, we need to break or deal with those grips. I'm gonna show that really fast. So if he has both high, usually I'm looking to pummel my arms under. As I go around, I can try to isolate for an overhook. I can build to a collar grip, which is what we're gonna do later. If his elbows are kind of tight, sometimes I'll push the biceps and then try to pummel. It makes it easier to get in. If he goes one high, one low, then often I'm looking for a cross sleeve grip. I go under, grab my own wrist, break, and now I can drag this arm across to go for the back or progress into other stuff. If he goes both low on the hips, usually I just double grip the lapel, I pull my knees forward, and I break his posture forward, and then now he's gonna have to put his hands either on the floor or on me to start trying to get his posture back, okay? If he's leaning back really far, usually I start threatening like a hip bump sweep like this, that'll either sweep him over or he'll drive back into me, and again, it kind of breaks the position, okay? So now what I'm looking for is once I break these positions, regardless of whatever setup he had, once I break these positions, what I'm gonna try to progress to is a good collar grip. Okay, so let's just say he starts both high. So I'm gonna pummel in here. Once I get in, I'm gonna go to the collar grip. And the key detail here is pinning your elbow to his chest, okay? A lot of people will get this collar grip and they start trying to work for stuff, but then the guy will re-pummel his arm in and now I can't pull. Once I pummel in and I pin my elbow to his chest, you can get in closer to see this, I pin my elbow to his sternum, he can no longer pummel underneath that. He can go underneath a little bit, but as long as my elbow's here, he doesn't have control, okay? So once I go here, I'm gonna pull this lapel out to get this a little bit tighter. It's hard for him to posture up. It's hard for him to posture up because of this grip, and that often exposes this collar choke, okay? I'm gonna progress to the arm bar, high guard in a second here, but the first thing that matters from this grip is anytime he leaves this open, I set this grip really tight. I go deep behind the neck, go around here to look at this. I go deep behind the neck and I wanna turn my palm up like this so I get the sharp part of the bone here to cut into his neck. Once it cuts into his neck, all I have to do with the second hand is grab this buildup of material that will naturally appear because of how much fabric I've pulled over. I don't even need to go inside the collar. I just grab here, I lock my forearm in front, I bring my chest to his chest, pull, and you get a nice tight collar choke, okay? This is kind of like the jab of this position. If he never respects that, you will finish with this. A lot of people think of the collar choke like it's just kind of this basic move you learn that you don't use a lot, but if you're really dangerous with it, it's a serious threat from the closed guard, okay? So again, we're here, I pummel, however, I get this collar grip, I crunch in and I start inching that tight. Now there's this constant threat of the collar choke. Often people will kind of put their forearm on you like this. Once he does this, I'm gonna go left hand behind his tricep here and I kind of bridge my hip and I drop and I pull his elbow over to about my belly button or on the center line somewhere. From here, I'm gonna unlock my legs, I hop my hips up and I kind of jump my hip out to the side angle a little bit and I can lock my leg over his shoulder. Once I'm here, now I'm controlling his posture, not just with my arm, but with my legs, okay? I could keep the collar grip here or I can start pulling my arm out to work for the arm bar. From here, the main thing to keep in mind is even though once I have this high guard, what I wanna focus on is squeezing my knees together tight and clamping my feet down. This makes the position much tighter and easier to move and navigate him. And if he starts trying to posture up, start posturing up, it's really hard for him to posture because this left leg that is over the shoulder is now breaking his posture, okay? The hard part with a classic armbar is if I'm here trying to go for an armbar, he can posture up, right? I can try to go here, but it's a large extra step, right? So I push across, I jump, now I'm controlling the posture of my legs, okay? So the first attack we're gonna go for from here is I'm now gonna lock his wrist down with my forearm here. I have the posture control of my left leg. Now I'm gonna use my left forearm to push his head away and kind of control the posture a little bit. Now I'm gonna unlock my legs and I hop my legs up over for the arm bar. I wanna make sure my left leg cuts high over his head. If I'm down here, he can kind of stack into me, right? So when I cut high over the head, this breaks his posture. My right leg I also want really high over the back. Now he can't posture up at all. I squeeze my knees together and I finish the arm bar. Make sure again, you're always squeezing your knees and clamping your feet down. Those small details make a huge, huge difference, okay? So another combination from here, once I set the position, is I'll get here and he's gonna try to like spiderweb his arms up like this, okay? Couple options you can do from here is one, I can just keep this grip. I'll grab the material over his shoulder here. I grab his pant leg with my right hand here, and now I kind of push in, I pull him into me, and he can't post his hand because it's trapped. So now I can pendulously sweep him up and come up into the mount here.
And now from here, I could either try to progress to an armbar or I could just take the mount and build from here.
So again, we're here, we get the collar, I crunch in and bring that elbow tight, elbow across, lock high here. I start going for this armbar. If I go over for the armbar and he spider webs again, another option if you can't get the pendulum sweep is, again, I keep the knees tight, feet down, is I'm just gonna focus on this wrist because my legs are holding him in position. I grab the elbow and the wrist, I bridge my hips up, and I'm gonna pull this across just like I'm about to go for an omoplata. And I could go for the omoplata, but once I pull this across, it's easy to go for the armbar. If he somehow pulls this arm out, I have the omoplata or the triangle choke I can go for. If I go for the omoplata here, I can start progressing. If he stands all the way up here, start standing all the way up, right here, and he postures out, it's easy to throw into this. It can start building in to a matrix from here as well. So keep in mind, when we're in closed guard, I have to take the attack he's giving me. I can't always force what I want. So if I bring him forward like this, I may end up going for an overhook if he doesn't put the forearm on my chest, right? Or if I have the forearm here and he doesn't go there, I can just push this wrist out and try to throw a triangle, okay? So you have to kind of build off what they give you. But in this video, I'm trying to focus on the high guard, okay? So again, we get the elbow across. So sometimes when I go up here, he's so focused on the armbar stuff or whatever, I can actually go back to the collar here. I get that same grip I showed you on the fabric here. I turn the wrist in, and now I threaten this again, okay? So again, this is like a really basic, classic attack series from closed guard, but a lot of people don't, they overlook closed guard. They don't realize how powerful it is. And as you develop a good open guard, being able to set up closed guard gives you access to so many different submissions and sweeps. So it's a huge weapon to have in your arsenal.
All right, guys, hope you like the content. Be sure to get, all right, guys. Fuck you, Robin. Okay, here, go back. Put your little fucking lame socks on. Okay. Namaste. Okay. Hope you guys like the video. If you guys have any requests, please sure to comment and let me know. And as always, if you guys like the content, like, share, subscribe. Thanks a lot.